There's been a school on this site for more than 50 years. And even in the early years, singing was a big part of school life. When Janice Pounds arrived at the school, which at that stage was called Greenland High School for Girls, there wasn't a regular choir.
I came along in 1997. When I arrived at school, it was very much a scenario of a choir being formed for a special event or a special occasion. And I think it was Anne Preston who really got the choir going in the early days. And she invited Margaret along to school.
I was at an engagement with some friends and I met a lady called Anne Preston, and she was asking me what I was doing, and I told her my work with choirs and being a vocal coach, and she informed me about a newly set up choir in Greenlands High School, as the school used to be called then, and she asked if I would come and listen to them. And I said, maybe not. And she said, please just come and listen to them. And I said, okay. So I came and listened, and I've been part of the choir ever since.
But why a gospel choir?
We had this long conversation, Anne and I, and we talked about what was of interest to students. And more often than not, if we called it choir, people or students had a sort of preconceived idea as to what sort of activity that would be. So in calling it a gospel choir and putting a little bit of a mix of popular music in there, it seemed to appeal to a wider range of students.
Anne and Janice had started this together, and when I went and I listened to them, I could hear the potential and I could see the energy of the students, the willingness to perform, and that's what swayed me. I then came into school. Janice Pounds was the head and the lead then, came into school, and it went from there really. It all just seemed to blossom from the beginning, from meeting Anne, then meeting Janice and the choir.
So Margaret came along, and believe it or not, and she'll hate me for saying it, but in the very, very early days, she was quite a nervous person, and I remember saying to her, well, I'll conduct this one, and then perhaps you can take over, or I'll conduct one and you can conduct one. And she was very, very reluctant at the start, but as soon as she got in front of the choir, and they were kind to her, I think it spurred her on, and now you see this person who's full of confidence and who excels in front of the singers, and I'm very proud of that, very proud of her.
Not long after Margaret's arrival, Richard Moore joined the team.
I joined the school in January 2000. Margaret and Janice were mainly in charge of the choir at this point, and having taken more of a back seat, I initially started working literally just as technical support. When I first started, Janice was head of department, and the other music teacher was Stuart Longley, with Andy Sykes, who was the arranger of many of the early choir backing tracks. Not long after Stuart Longley left and Katie Morgan came on board, followed not long after that by David Cookson.
It was either 2000 or 2001. I'd been working at Blackpool-on-the-Fylde College, and I did some part-time work at Bispham High School in the music IT department. And Mrs. Pounds very kindly asked me if I would like to play the organ for the carol service at Christmas, which was at North Shore Methodist. And I did that, and that's when I very first encountered the choir.
One other person who can't be left out of this story is the late Ian Holdsworth.
Ian Holdsworth was always incredibly supportive. that was the point where we were looking to become an arts college and we were embracing the arts as a school. Ian totally supported and lived all the experiences that we had and always supported the concerts, spent hours behind the scenes. That was Ian's strength. He was always behind the scenes.
Ian was at every concert. He often used to compare them. He used to drive me mad with his dreadful way of holding a microphone. But he was someone who was a real backbone to everything that we did in those early days.
In 2003, Janice Pounds left the school and a new head of music arrived in the shape of Neil Oldham.
My first impressions of the choir were when I came round and had a look when I was on interview. I thought the choir sounded absolutely brilliant. I thought, oh, they're something really special.
A short while later, Sarah Baygott came to the school.
I joined the school in 2004 and I've been here ever since.
Yeah, we keep trying to lose her. We tried in France, and Germany, and Belgium, but she keeps following us back.
In 1999, Greenland became Bispham High School and achieved Arts College status.
I was here obviously when we were trying to get the grant to be a performing arts school, so we were performing everywhere, and then when we finally got it, the choir just grew and it became something brilliant.
The Gospel Choir established themselves in the community very quickly, helped in part by the tours that they took part in around local primary schools.
My favourite memories have to be Christmas memories, to be honest. That was the real hub of choir activity, especially in sort of the early days of the choir. Just as we got performing arts status at the school, we did outreach at Christmas at the primary schools and we all absolutely loved it.
Christmas primary tours, 100%. They were highlight of the year. They were so fun, and every school we went to, the children just loved it. It was wonderful.
We also entered our first competitions.
The choir won the Rotary competition. I'd been taking part in the Rotary music competition for a few years as a soloist, but then taking part in the choir was a great experience, and then to win was just a brilliant occasion.
Every summer from 1999 to 2004, the school organised a concert at the Winter Gardens with Blackpool Area School Symphony Orchestra, and the choir became an integral part of the evening. In the early days of the choir, there was one song that we became particularly identified with.
First time the gospel choir performed Joyful, Joyful on stage. And it was the first time the Greenland's audience at that time had seen their geek perform a rap on stage to Joyful, Joyful, and to see my the girls in my class falling off their chairs with laughter was brilliant.
Joyful, joyful, Lord, we adore thee, and in my life I put none before thee. Cause since I was a youngster, I came to know that you was the only way to go. So I had to grow and come to an understanding. Then I'm down with the king, so I know what the man think. Then you tell me who you
are. Can still remember it, like word for word. I must have practiced it so much.
You know a G-O-D. You know a G-O-D.
It was synonymous with our school choir, with the Bispham High School Gospel Choir.
At the Christmas concert in 2002, we introduced a song that's almost become the choir's signature tune.
The song that choir have done is probably Jesus, because It's genuinely a fun song to sing.
I think Jesus is the one that stands out. It was our staple song, and it was one that no other school could sing, and that only all of our students knew. No problem. All you have to do is hear that those first few chords, and everyone knows exactly what we're going to sing. And Margaret starts dancing. All of this one. That was my favourite.
Over the years, the choir has taken part in and won a number of competitions, starting with the Rotary Music Competition in 2001. In 2004 and 2007, we were awarded the Robinson Rolls Bowl at Blackpool Music Festival for Best Choir and the G.O. Marshall Cup for the Best Conductors. And in October 2006, we won the John Edgar Mills Trophy for the Best Choir in the Fleetwood Music and Arts Festival. We have made two albums, which were the first ever issued on iTunes by a British high school choir. As a result, our recordings have sold all over the world, to Australia and New Zealand, the USA, South Africa and Japan. Of all the events we take part in Blackpool, our own concerts are perhaps the favourites. From the many churches, including North Shore Methodists, St Stephen's on the Cliffs, Springfield Methodists, Christ Church and St John's Churches in Thornton. And earlier this year, St Paul's in Martham. To the many summer and Christmas concerts performed in our own school hall. The choir have regularly performed at top Blackpool venues like the Winter Gardens Complex, Blackpool Tower, and the Grand Theatre. And even in a barn at an animal sanctuary. But we didn't confine ourselves to Blackpool alone. We've taken part in concerts at the Bridgewater Hall in Manchester. The O2 Arena in London. And at gospel concerts in Warrington and Liverpool, thanks to our links with Janice Pounds, now head of Warrington Music Service. We have also made four successful trips to Europe. This has brought us some fabulous opportunities. Singing at Disneyland, in the shadow of the Eiffel Tower, the Gospel Knocked Festival in Bottrop, and in the town squares in Ypres and Ostend. I'll follow, It's also a lot of fun, with many theme parks visited. Flash mobs, where we sang everywhere from a North Sea ferry to outside Cologne Cathedral. Not to mention throwing Mr. Oldham into a swimming pool.
I joined in year 8. My sister was already in there. I was recommended to by Margaret, who I'd seen once or twice for some singing lessons. And then I heard there was a concert and they needed singers, they needed boys. So me and my friend decided to join, and I was there till my very last concert in year 11.
When I came on an open evening, I was particularly interested in the music. We came up and somebody actually told me about the choir. So then when I started school, the first thing I did was come up and find out when it started and came and joined.
Because I was doing singing lessons with Margaret and she was going, you have to join the choir. Join the choir. So I did.
My sister was in the choir and she really enjoyed it, so.
Going past the department and hearing everybody singing from the stairs, and I used to just go past and think, I want to be a part of that, that sounds really good. So I came upstairs and slid in carefully and stayed at the front and never moved back.
When I was at school, didn't particularly like school, who does? But the choir made me love it. So the choir as a whole for me was amazing.
While I was at school, I was really pushed to do well academically, and the choir provided an outlet for me. It was the one thing I can look back at school and think, I absolutely loved every second of it.
The choir meant more than just gathering together and singing songs and doing the odd concert. I remember struggling for a while with certain aspects of high school, but there was always the knowledge that at some point in the day, in the week, I would go into a room with my best of friends and my favourite teachers, and we would gather together and sing these amazing songs.
I think the choir is special because it's every child is so individual, and they come together and they spark up this common relationship. And passion for singing and for making music. They support each other through an awful lot of things, and they become almost like a family within school. And I think that's what's made it so special, and that's why we've achieved so much.
I think we are very professional, and I think when we perform, we make sure that the performances are very polished. We never put a performance on that hasn't been completely pulled apart and then put back together.
I always felt there was, when we went to things like Schools Alive and we performed there, other schools had, we were their benchmark, and I don't think a lot of the schools can say that.
And I think I can say with absolute certainty that I worked with just some of the most amazing teachers I've ever met in my life. I couldn't think of any other people that would lead that choir better. You know, Margaret and Neil and Sarah and Paul and Richard and everyone throughout the years as it's changed.
I used to enjoy introducing the song Jesus, and I always used to say, I'm not going to tell you what the song's called, but by the end of the song you'll know.
I think my favourite memory was going to Disneyland. Not many people can say they've performed with Disneyland, haven't they?
Ooh, trips are my favourite memories. So we've been Germany twice, but Paris and Belgium. Just the laughs that we have on those trips, especially when the staff dress up as some sort of bizarre singing group and perform something very stupid.
Oh, the tours. The tours were such fun.
I think the tours that we've done are my favourite memories. You know, I think they'll stay with me for a long while, as they probably will with the children. I think the best concert for me was in Germany, the first time we went to Germany, when the audience were just absolutely wowed by the choir, and they were all stood up on the feet at the end clapping, asking them for more, and then they were emailing us when we got back to say, oh, can you bring them back? We want to see them again.
My favourite memory of being in choir was when we toured Belgium. When we sung in the town centre, loads of people were just pulling up chairs and watching us. I thought it was really cool just to be a part of.
They've all been good memories, really.
Everything, you see, absolutely everything we do with the choir, our finished article, is always amazing. So every single time we do something, I always say, that was the best. So there's not one that stands out, it's just that every single time, it's the best.
I suppose before I joined the choir, I'd never sang in a group and never really had much experience singing on stage anyway, so it definitely helped when I was doing the run-up to my drama school auditions. And I did end up getting into drama school, and an awful lot of it was singing, especially through college as well, when I had to do A-level music and I had to pick up harmonies really quickly. All of my choir knowledge came running back to me, and I've been in a lot of choirs since this one, so it's definitely been a big help.
My friends are a big one, because obviously the people that I still talk to and the people I meet up with, you can't replace those friendships, and I think without the choir I wouldn't have had that.
I've got a lot of lasting friends. I'm still friends with people who I was in the choir with when I first started, and they will always be my friends. Music's a wonderful thing for meeting people who are like-minded and having a laugh and sharing great experiences, great moments. Performing on stage really brings you together.
Bispham High School Gospel Choir will always remain a very, very, very happy time of my life, a very joyful one. One that I don't think I'll be forgetting for many, many years to come.
The idea of a reunion had been around for a couple of years, but with the merger of Bispham with Collegiate, it seemed like the perfect time to get everybody back together. A Facebook page was set up, and we tried to trace as many ex-choir members and staff as possible. This was followed up by a two-page spread in the Gazette. This resulted in a quite amazing response, and if everyone comes, you said they would, we could well have trouble fitting them all on stage.
Very fitting tribute to say goodbye to Bispham High School, to give people an opportunity to come back together for one last time, just to sing some of the old favourites and say hello to people and tell us their story and what they've gone on to achieve is a really wonderful thing to do.
I think the purpose for doing the reunion now is we felt that it was important, whilst it's important to look forward as to where we're going to, it's important to remember where we've come from, and it's nice to say thank you to everyone who's been involved. It's nice to know that people still support us and still care about the journey that we're on. And it's great to have an opportunity to bring all our old students and friends back together to do something that they all still love doing. And sing together one last time.
It's always exciting for a new beginning, because let's face it, every year we have a new beginning because we have so many year 11s that leave, so we have to reform the choir. Very sad that the name will change, because it's been a name that's known throughout Blackpool and throughout Europe and worldwide, really, because of the albums that are on iTunes. It'll be sad for the name to be changed. I'm sure I'm going to have plenty of tears on the night of the concert, but it's a new beginning. And with that new beginning is new energy and new ideas. And we carry on and keep building on the strengths that we have.
I think the reunion is going to be fabulous. I can't wait to see so many people again. I've met a few of them once more through doing these interviews, and it's great to see the people they've grown up into.